என் பாப்பாவுக்கு இப்போ 2 வயசு ஆகுது. 1 வயசு ஆகும்போது அவன் முதுகில் ஒரு கட்டி இருந்துச்சு. அதை என்னன்னு பார்த்து கவர்மெண்ட் ஹாஸ்பிட்டல் கூட்டின்னு போயிட்டு கேட்டதுக்கு கொழுப்பு கட்டின்னு சொன்னாங்க. அது ஃபுல்லாக ஆப்ரேஷன் பண்ணி எடுக்கணும், 1,75,000 ஆகும்னு சொன்னாங்க. எங்களால் அவ்வளோ கொடுத்து பண்ண முடியாதுன்னு சொன்னோம். இப்போ பாப்பாவுக்கு ஆப்ரேஷன் பண்ணி 6 மாதம் ஆயிடுச்சு. என் பாப்பாவுக்கு ஹெல்ப் பண்ண ஏகம் ஃபவுண்டேஷனுக்கு ரொம்ப நன்றி.
This is where Ekam got started, and we started in the Cancer Children Ward initially to start with, and we started supporting life-saving drugs, equipments, manpower and lab investigation support, which is very much essentially needed for the child's survival when any child comes and gets admitted in the hospital. And sometimes in a public healthcare system, because of the compromise in the infrastructure support and the facilities, the children die. So this is where being a pediatrician witnessing children dying, wish there would be a system where we can complement the public healthcare system and support them so that many children can survive, because all the resources are available except that there could be a shortage of a drug or sometimes an equipment. If we can just complement that part of it, then the child would survive.
This hospital is seeing an outpatient flow of 2,000 to 4,000 footfalls every day, and an inpatient strength of 800 to 1,200 inpatients, that is children who are sick and being treated every day. And on this aspect, I want to thank Ekam Foundation, which is associated with this hospital for a very long time and giving their unconditional support on various aspects.
Ekam got started in 2009 as a completely, it was in a charity mode. So it was a completely spiritual journey for me, because being a pediatrician, when a child comes very sick to the hospital, the parent is standing in front of us and actually, you know, he is in a dilemma whether what he can do. Like, we would be talking to him about the child is very sick, can you admit the child in the hospital? It would cost so much. And imagine a parent who is so stressed whether the child is going to live or not, and about that we would be asking him, would you be able to bear the cost? The thought process of a parent would be, I would rather lose this kid and have another kid which is more economical. So that's extremely painful to witness, and directly when we are witnessing, then the thought process came like, why have I done pediatrics? Is it that if a parent has money, I would take care of the child, and if they don't have money, I would not? So that was where the seed for Ekam got started. And it started with a vision that no child should be refused of treatment because of financial constraints, and no parent should feel guilty that he's not able to afford, and no hospital should refuse treatment. So it all started off in a charity mode, and then slowly it became a public-private partnership model with the government. Started complementing with the government healthcare system, and slowly expanded to the rest of the hospitals in Tamil Nadu.
Past 9 years, the coordination between the government and the Ekam Foundation was very excellent. In fact, they all started in 2010 when we started putting NICU throughout the state to bring down the mortality of newborns. Ekam Foundation is the one who came along with the government, and they did a very big job of recruiting the staff nurses for all the NICUs. In fact, Ekam along with us have appointed more than 1,000 staff nurses throughout the state.
So far, over a period of 5 years, we recruited around 3,000 nurses for the government, and completely we took care of the training part in partnership with the government. And their salaries were completely borne by the government, but we took care of implementation part, the payroll processing, and we facilitated training along with the government training centers, and saw that they got placed.
So Ekam Foundation, with all their engineers in this NGO group, they came forward to repair all the equipments, and we had an excellent MOU with the Ekam Foundation, and we saw see to that all the equipments which are getting repaired are repaired in 48 hours. So not only the doctors or the nurses, these equipments are very essential in saving the lives of many newborns, and this is one of the best achievements Tamil Nadu has done through Ekam Foundation by making an MOU to see to that all the equipments are getting repaired. In fact, this model of repairing the equipment in NICU is now being taken up and followed by other states in the North India.
So over a period of time, with the staffing, training, equipment maintenance in Tamil Nadu, in complementing with the government system, it brought down the mortality rate from 21 to 16.
And they have also been helping us in some of the essential drugs. Sometimes when we need certain drugs for some rare conditions, Ekam has been coming forward immediately and supporting in procuring the drugs and immediately administering to the patient and saving many children's life.
Over a period of time, the model got replicated to other states like Chhattisgarh, where the mortality is so high. And now the staffing, training, equipment maintenance part has been scaled up in almost 18 districts in Chhattisgarh, and which is bringing down the mortality rate, and the government there is very happy. We partnered there with UNICEF and Chhattisgarh Health Department. The value addition of Ekam, if anybody would ask why can't it be outsourced to a vendor rather than Ekam, I think for us the business is saving lives rather than earning money. So that is what made a difference. I would like to thank trustees, advisors, Ekam team, donors and volunteers for all their amazing unconditional support to the cause, without whom this would not have been possible. And especially we need lots and lots of volunteers who could actually join us and take this movement forward to reach out to many more children and mothers.